School. I am your science teacher. We are learning chapter 2, Is Matter Around Us Pure? Now today what we are going to see is a new process called crystallization. Now how can you obtain a pure copper substance from an impure sample? Or you must have seen how do they prepare salt from sea water. Okay, so let me explain you first copper sulfate. Take some impure sample of copper sulfate in a china dish. Right, some impure, you have to dissolve it first, then you have to filter out all pure impurities. Third, then you just have to evaporate, either by the means of nature or with the help of by giving heat. When you evaporate water, cover that solution with a filter paper and leave it undisturbed at room temperature. You just have to leave it undisturbed, and finally after evaporation what you get is a crystals of copper sulfate. The way you get a crystals of salt, okay. This method or this process is called crystallization, okay. The crystallization method is used to purify solids, right. It also helps you to remove the impurities. So basically crystallization is a process that separates a pure solid, okay. So we are talking here is, so we that separates a pure solid in the form of crystals from a solution. So that is it about it. The next what we are talking is, how can you obtain the same sugar salt from it? So you know what they do is they dig the big area. Then they pour some sea water into it. Why sea water? Because it is salty. Once they pour it into it, they keep it for a month. So basically the evaporation process happens and finally what you get is a salt. So some solid will decompose and some like sugar may be charged on heating to dryness. So basically sugar also the same thing happened from the sugarcane juice. They used to separate the things like this. Some impurities can be dissolved after filtration and some can be evaporated, right? So this is how you get purification of salt from seawater. Even the crystals of alum pitkari, that is like people earlier used to use it after the after shaving, that's it's like a stone kind of thing. Okay, now we are going to see the another separating technique for drinking water. How do they purify, right? So simple, let's say this is a reservoir, the way we have of it in Navsari, it's a Dudhiyathada. Then the sedimentation tank is there to allow the solid settlement. So basically they keep the water inside it, so the solid matter get deposited. Then it goes to the other thing, loading tank. To sediment in the suspended impurities, suspended means dissolved impurities. Next they pass it from a filtration tank from it. Fine sand, gravel or all these things, and the last is killing bacteria by chlorination. So basically they chlorinate the water and that's final water what you get is a our pure water. Okay, so it's very easy and a simple process. You just have to understand what exactly it means. Okay, now the next what we are talking is, so this is one simple thing, right? Now so this is reservoir to allow settlement to sediments, water, fine gravel and etc. Right, and finally the whole process continue like this. Okay, I hope you are getting what I'm trying to say. Now let's see what next. Now what we are going to see is physical and chemical changes. So physical and chemical changes is, in previous chapter we have learned about physical properties of matter, right? Now, physical properties is what, when you touch it, you feel it, you can do all those things with the help of physical properties. So those are physical properties. So in physical properties, color, hardness, rigidity, fluidity, all these things matter. Right? The interconversation of the state is a physical change. Interconversation of a state is without change in the composition, we call it as a physical change. No change in the chemical nature, right? During physical change, there should be no change in the chemical nature. So this is one thing, no change in the chemical nature, only the physical change. Second thing what we are talking is color, hardness, rigidity, fluidity, density, melting point, boiling point, all are physical properties. This all are, we call it as a physical properties. Okay. So understand this small things, those are called physical properties. Now, the next thing what we are talking is the conversion of the state is a physical change, because this change is occurred without change in a composition. Although ice, water, water vapor, they all are different, and different physical properties, they are chemically the same. So both water and cooking oil are liquid, but the chemically chemical natures are different. Okay, so they differ in color and inflammability. The oil burns in air while the water is a fire extinguisher. They look same, but still they have a chemical change. So chemical change is the chemical properties of the matter, right? A chemical change is also called a chemical reaction. And physical properties, as what I'd say, it has many factors, include color, hardness, rigidity, fluidity, density, melting point, boiling point. All these are physical properties, and those are called chemical properties. Okay. So hope you are getting what I'm trying to say. Physical properties, chemical properties. Clear, everyone? So understand this small things here. Physical properties, chemical property. Next is a very small topic. So next lecture, we are going to complete our chapter. Fine. Thank you so much.